So I was planning to record a few slow motion pickup tests from underneath the Dyson Ball Animal 2, but after setting it all up, I remembered that the new Dyson uprights, like the Ball Animal 2 and the Multifloor 2, have extremely poor performance when picking up larger debris on hard floors. The problem is the active base plate, which is a great invention that Dyson patented, which automatically adjusts to the floor size in order to maximize suction. It's great for situations like getting debris out of crevices and some types of hard floors because of the suction the active base plate can help generate. But if you have debris of almost any size on top of the floor, it's a serious disappointment. This seems like an issue that could be fixed if there was some way that the active base plate could be adjusted manually, but they can't. These newer Dysons also seem to have a major flaw in that they have no way to adjust their motor or their very powerful suction in any way. If you look at the reviews, which I'll link below, you'll see that the customers are saying the same thing that I noticed in our review of the Ball Animal 2. It just won't work if your carpet is too thick. It certainly won't work for longer carpets, but even if it's just too thick, the suction makes it incredibly difficult to push and practically useless. These are serious issues with relatively easy fixes. I'm hoping that Dyson doesn't stop developing uprights as their press releases with the V10 seem to suggest, because these are decent vacuums that just need these two updates in order to be great vacuums. I'll link our review to the Dyson Ball Animal 2 on the left, and our video of whatever our current favorite vacuum is on the right. Consider a like or a subscription if this video helped you out, and thanks for watching.